concrete, steel, buildings, bridges, roads, railway systems. These are examples of we civil engineers use and build for the benefit of our society. Hello, I'm Jack, Associate Professor and UG Coordinator of the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering at Hong Kong University. In this talk, I will briefly introduce you what civil and environmental engineering is, some examples of civil engineering works in Hong Kong, and our programs at Hong Kong University. What is civil engineering? What is the difference between civil engineering and architecture? Architects consider the overall design. On the other hand, civil engineers are the ones who make sure the design are structurally feasible and optimal, the one who make the design into reality, and the one who ensure the spill follows the design finally. Civil engineering covers buildings, bridges, and many other types of infrastructure. We sometimes see buildings and bridges of interesting shapes, or very tall buildings and very long bridges. We need civil engineers to think about how to build them. So, what actually is civil engineering? Civil engineering, 土木工程, is not only some sort of engineering, it is mirror to changes and challenges through which human civilization has thrived out. In short, civil engineering is to engineer civilized environment for the mankind. What do we study in civil engineering? We can group them into six areas. Area 1 is structural and material engineering. Structural engineers consider the structural requirements of buildings and bridges, what materials to be used, what structural form in the design, and how much concrete and steel to be used. For example, we have many tall buildings in Hong Kong. We need to consider wind load and run different simulations to see the structural performance of different design. In Chinese, 土木工程 is a better illustration of the meaning of civil engineering. 土 means soil, and 木 means wood. In the old time, we built buildings using wood, but also need to consider the soil foundation of a building. That's why we have geotechnical engineering, which considers foundation of buildings and infrastructure such as piles, retaining walls, land reclamation, slopes, soil profile, underground structures like tunnels. For example, during heavy rain, will some slopes collapse? If we use underground water, will the ground level be affected? Another area is environmental engineering. It covers many environmental aspects related to the built environment, such as drinking water and wastewater treatment, green buildings, air quality, noise pollution, carbon footprint, etc. Fourth area is water resource engineering. If you remember, in 2018, we had Typhoon Silo number 8, which has seriously flooded Macau but not Hong Kong. It is actually the achievement of civil engineers who avoid flooding, plan the drainage system, catchment of rainwater, construction and maintenance of reservoirs, etc. The fifth area is transportation engineering. We do not build this high-speed rail nor the cars, but we build the roads and rails that trains and cars can travel on. We also design, construct, and maintain these transportation systems. For example, how can we direct the traffic from one tunnel to another one? It is the question that we try to solve. In a building project, we have tens to hundreds of people working on construction sites. For big projects like airport and major bridges, we could have thousands of workers on site. They have different names, different skill set, different tasks. System engineering and management study the management of this manpower, finance, resources, etc. in building and infrastructure projects. Advanced information technologies like BIM, sensing technologies are adopted to support all these projects. Civil engineers also try to avoid natural hazards. We holistically provide solutions from various aspects such as structural, geotechnical, water resources, and transportation engineering. So we try to solve the situation like the earthquake and also tsunami, as you can see in this slide. We now often hear smart cities. A city cannot have no buildings or no roads. We are integrating technologies like sensors and big data to buildings and bridges, making them smarter. We civil engineers now not only design and construct buildings and civil infrastructure, but also smart ones, making our environment more green, resilient, comfortable, and livable. After looking at the background of civil and environmental engineering, let's look at some exciting civil engineering developments in Hong Kong and neighbor regions. It is the forecast of the construction works in Hong Kong conducted by Construction Industry Council in 2019. We can see that the number of construction works have been increasing and the trend will continue in future years. Looking backwards, in 2007-2008 policy address, 10 major infrastructure projects were launched, creating many opportunities in civil and construction engineering industry. It is the list of 10 major infrastructure projects in Hong Kong. Some have been completed, such as the number one South Island Line, so that we have MTR station at Ocean Park now. We have also completed Express Rail Link and the Hong Kong Zhuhai Macau Bridge. But you can see that we still have some which are ongoing, such as Sha Tin Central Link, West Kowloon Cultural District, and Kai Tak area. Some like Lok Ma Chau area and Hong Shui Kiu area are still far from finish. So you don't need to worry that there's no project in the future. How many of you have been to a Hong Kong Zhuhai Macau Bridge? It is one of the 10 major infrastructure projects. It greatly reduces the travel time from Hong Kong to Macau and Zhuhai. If you have been to the bridge, you will be amazed by what civil engineers built. The Kai Tak development area, together with Kwun Tong and Kowloon Bay District, will provide 5.4 million square meters of office space and is positioned as the second central business district, CBD2, in Hong Kong. It will also provide many residential flats as well. It means that there will be a lot of buildings to be designed and constructed in this area in recent years. Besides the 10 major infrastructure projects, we are also building the third runway for the Hong Kong International Airport. As you can see in this picture, we need to extend the airport by half to build the third runway. It is similar to building half of the entire airport, which creates many jobs for civil and environmental engineering. In fact, the Hong Kong government is already planning what Hong Kong will look like in 2030 and beyond. There will be another CBD in East Kowloon and in North Lantau Island. There will be a new piece of land linking Lantau Island and the Hong Kong Island. It means that in the future, there will be many opportunities for new buildings and civil infrastructure. In the future, we will also see more civil infrastructure like water treatment plants to be relocated to caverns, so that we can have more land for residential buildings. Construction in caverns will require more studies and be the future trend. So you can see that civil engineering actually covers many exciting directions. Our civil and environmental engineering programs prepare our students to have solid foundation in all these six areas. Our program has met the requirement of the four divisions of Hong Kong Institutions of Engineers, Hong Kong IE, which are civil, structural, geotechnical, and environmental engineering. Our students can get chartership under the scheme training, which will be faster than those who study civil engineering from some overseas countries. Our civil and environmental engineering programs cover 4 years. First year is general engineering, and then students will take civil engineering fundamental and specialty courses starting year two. You can see that the program covers totally 126 credits in our program. This is the program structure of the civil and environmental program in HKUST. You can see that some courses are offered in fall, some are in spring, and some are in both semesters. We also have some modules in summer semester. On average, each student will take about 5 to 6 courses per semester. The workload is not that heavy actually. What's special about our program is we require students to take industrial training, internship, and final year project and capstone design project before they graduate. They keep our students busy in summer and within the semester, but at the same time, they are fruitful to our students and make our students more marketable and easier to find jobs when they graduate. So they are actually good to our students and make our program attractive. It shows the professional path of our CIVL engineering graduates. If they are admitted to our program at Hong Kong UST next year in 2021, you will graduate in 2025 and can start the 4-year Hong Kong RE scheme training. After 4 years, you can be a professional engineer chartered under Hong Kong RE. Afterwards, you can be further promoted to senior engineer, chief engineer, or even partner and director of different engineering firms. It shows the employment situation of our graduates. In last year, 2019, 64% of our graduates work in consultant, 20% work in contractor, and some work in government or pursue PG study. It shows the salary of our graduates. It is only for reference. There are fluctuations in the salary range, but overall it is attractive and one of the engineering programs the graduates of which get the highest salary. CIVL engineering is a global profession. Our alumni have been involved in various exciting projects all over the world. For example, Kylie Lam has been involved in the design and construction of bird nest in Beijing and CCTV tower in Guangzhou, which was the tallest structure when it was built in China. Do you know the tallest building in the world? It is Burj Khalifa, shown in this picture. Our graduate, Trafa Chong, has been involved in the design and construction of the Burj Khalifa, which is in Dubai. And you can see that CIVL engineering actually provides our alumni different opportunities. It is the latest university ranking of HKUST. HKUST is ranked 27th globally. Our CIVL and environmental engineering is ranked 17th in the whole world and number one in Hong Kong. So Hong Kong UST is your best choice. You can see that CIVL and environmental engineering is an exciting profession. There are many interesting yet challenging opportunities waiting for you. If you are ready to be challenged, please join us. If you want to know more about our programs or if you have any questions, please feel free to contact us. We have just covered some opportunities and challenges in the built environment. We welcome all of you who are talented and want to contribute to our society. We hope to see you soon at Hong Kong UST. Thank you.